a tough act to follow from a man who has always been tough, not with words, but with actions. Days after Hurricane Maria struck the island, we got phone call from the senator. Councilman Aníbal Ramos and Councilman Quintana and I joined him at Newark International Airport, and he said, if this president is not going to aid me in getting there, I'm going to do everything that I can to get there on my own. And that he did. And from his trip, he sent us pictures and updates, and then came back with an agenda and a commitment stronger than ever to be sure that he would fight for every Puerto Ricano on the island the way he has always fought for every Puerto Ricano and every Latino here in this state, but in this country. But let's have an honest discussion. When you have a president who is tweeting about the numbers of fatalities without even recognizing a common sense approach, if it took nearly a year to restore electricity, you have to recognize that those dire circumstances lends itself to death numbers that will reach to 3,000 and probably above. When you have a president who's taking an inhumane approach to a humanitarian crisis, then you realize the catastrophic measure that is currently happening today. We dealt with Hurricane Maria a year ago. Today, we deal with Hurricane Trump and his inability to rescue American citizens on the island. There are details of numbers that FEMA has denied over 300,000 homeowners some kind of benefit to restore their homes. We have to rally around this and demand more. We have bills in the legislature that call to divest from banks who are taking benefit of the foreclosure crisis. And we have to ask this administration to take on that initiative and sign the bill so that New Jersey shows its strength and its power, that we are committed to revitalizing Puerto Rico. And we have to take a moment and pause and pray for our families and for those lives that were lost. But then after that, we have to stand up and say, Puerto Rico siempre pa'lante. Puerto Rico va a llegar más fuerte, con más poder, con más amor. Because I can tell you this, and for all of you who don't know Puerto Ricans, you may knock us down, but when we get back up, we get back stronger and ready to fight. Yes. I just want to pivot for a second that we have to be sure that when we rebuild, we don't lose sight of what's happening now. There was a beautiful CNN story today about the Sisterhood of Recovery, and you see that women are taking leadership roles and reinventing the industry of farming and fashion back on the island. So there's pockets of hope from one corner of Camoy all the way to San Sebastian. But there's also another story that's happening in Puerto Rico, and that's the advantage of tax credits from the wealthy who are taking advantage of this crisis. So they make millions and billions of dollars here in the state, and now they're calling Puerto Rico their home, but they're not contributing to the restoration efforts. And so I look to Senator Menendez to be sure that there's fairness and equity as we rebuild. But I look to him to say thank you. Thank you for the work that you have done and for the work that you will continue to do. Boricua soy y siempre seré. Yeah.